Hi, my name is Sahba, and I'm a graduate student at the National Institutes of Health. An estimated 50,000 people in the US alone suffer from a form of dementia called frontotemporal dementia, or FTD for short. This disease slowly destroys the brain, erases memories, and results in personality, language, and movement problems, and there's no effective treatment. What's more, the underlying cause of FTD can differ between patients, which makes it difficult to get clear results from clinical trials testing treatments for it, since a treatment that targets one cause may work for some patients, but not for others. I'm working to help solve that problem by developing a way for researchers to pinpoint the specific driver of disease in individual patients. My efforts focus specifically on a protein called TDP43 that stops working properly in the brains of about half of all people with FTD. To understand what TDP43 does, you can think of your DNA as a rough draft of a film that has all the final scenes but also still contains the outtakes. Similarly, your genes have regions within them that contain important genetic information called exons, interspersed with extra stretches of DNA called introns. TDP43 acts kind of like a film editor for your genes, helping to selectively cut out the unneeded parts from the initial version to produce the final cut, a mature RNA molecule that the cell can use to make proteins. But in FTD patients with defective TDP43, certain outtakes called cryptic exons stick around, and we think that detecting these outtakes in patients' spinal fluid could offer a glimpse into how the disease is affecting their brain. My colleagues and I have so far identified hundreds of these cryptic exons that stick around in isolated neurons with drastically reduced levels of TDP43, and we've been able to confirm that at least 49 of them are present in the brains of FTD patients. What's especially exciting about this is that problems with TDP43 happen not only in FTD, but also in other neurological disorders like ALS and Alzheimer's disease. So this work has the potential to revolutionize the way we test treatments for a number of devastating conditions that affect millions of people around the world.